Hello and welcome. My name is Drew Robertson and I'm a mechanical engineer with Matrix Technologies. In this video, I'd like to look at a line OEE simulation for a spirits production line. One of our clients came to us looking for some control updates to their existing line to help boost the efficiency. Right now they're running at about 30 to 60% OEE, depending on the product they're running. For this case study, we're looking at the 750 milliliter glass bottles. It's one of their higher volume products and about 51% OEE today. And like a lot of lines out there, there's not a lot of extra accumulation on the line. So it kind of involves looking a little bit more in depth into the conveyor control strategy and if it's viable to add more equipment to the line to improve those efficiency numbers. So what is OEE? It is the overall equipment effectiveness. It's made up of availability, performance, and quality. The simulation that we're doing today is really just focused on performance. It's taking into account equipment downtime to calculate the total case count over a certain time period. We also take into account with this a quality factor to help get it to that OEE number, and that factor also takes into account some of the availability numbers. Oh, for this line, this is just an overview of the equipment that's there. The line can run either plastic bottles or glass bottles. For this case, we are looking at the glass bottles up into the case sealer. The palletizer is far enough downstream, it's not affecting our OEE. And then from being on site, we noticed there's a few pieces of equipment that are a little bit more troublesome. Like the case packer was having trouble keeping up with rate. And then the labeler and the filler are so close coupled that if one of them goes down, the other one's taken down almost immediately. For this line, we also had Traxxas data to calculate downtime events, the mean time between failures, mean time to repair. These are very important as we go to build our model. We want to know how each piece of equipment is functioning and how often it's running into an issue. Also from that Traxxas data, we get this nice Pareto chart. And this doesn't directly go into the simulation, but it helps with the knowledge of what we do with accumulation and how much accumulation we should have. From this chart, we can see that about 60% of all of the events are 1 minute or less in duration, and 75% are 2 minutes or less in duration. So this kind of tells you that if you can get 2 minutes of accumulation or buffer between pieces of equipment, you're going to get a lot of those events taken care of and covered so that when your labeler goes down, it's not immediately taking out the filler. You have 2 minutes before you start taking down other pieces of equipment and affecting the overall effectiveness. And ideally, you would want infinite accumulation, but for cost and space issues, that's rarely ever feasible. So now that we have the Traxxas downtime data and we have an overview of our equipment and how they flow together, we can hop into the simulation and we can change a few variables in there to quantify the impact of some of our planned changes and see how those will affect the overall case count. And then we don't have to do that on site while they're trying to make product, and we don't really want to be affecting their daily rates with that testing. So in process analysis, this looks very similar to the PFD. Each block is a piece of equipment, and we're pulling in that mean time between failures and mean time to repair into each one of these pieces of equipment. And we have the production rates in here as well. Everything's set for the original speed of 185 bottles per minute that we saw on site. And then each one of the lines in between represents a set of conveyors, and it's going to have the transportation time in there. How fast is the bottle going from the filler to the labeler? And then how much capacity is on that conveyor? Just a quick preview of what the simulation looks like. When we run the simulation, it's putting in blue dots to to represent the empty bottles coming in. They get filled, labels added, and then go to the drop case backer. As this is running, we'll see some of them come up with little red stop signs that mean there was an issue at that piece of equipment. So it's down, not producing any bottles. The stuff downstream may start to see a lack of bottles, and stuff upstream may see blocked bottles. So we can run that simulation for different scenarios, and then we can always go back and increase how fast the conveyors are running or decrease the transportation time. This effectively is changing the spacing between the bottles, getting bottles to the drop case packer faster to keep it running. But also, if that drop case packer goes down, that space between the bottles can now start to build back up with bottles. So it's acting as sort of a buffer between the labeler and the drop case packer without having to add equipment. But we are also able to add new equipment in here. We can add another buffer between the filler and the labeler, and then you can draw them in, and we could go back and update our model to have a new piece of equipment in there and add that buffer between the filler and the labeler. So after each one of those tests, we get a nice results printout that talks about the units produced in during that test over that time period, and then the average production rate. You also get a nice little graphic that shows the downtime for each piece of equipment and the block time and the idle time. Ideally, we're trying to reduce or eliminate the idle or block time by adding buffers, running conveyors faster, and ramping up that equipment speed to keep bottles moving through the entire line. And then this is kind of the results page of some of the simulations we did. The first simulation we did was just to compare our model to what we saw on site. Got the same OEE number with that 9% reduction that we used to account for bad product rework and some of the availability issues that's not captured in the Traxxas data. We also simulated what happens if we can reprogram the line, get conveyors running a little bit faster, equipment running a little bit faster, just get back up to the design rate of 200 bottles per minute, and then even maybe faster to 220. Could see a 4 to 15% OEE increase. If the ROI makes sense and capital is available, we can also start looking at adding equipment, adding a wider conveyor feeding the drop case packer. That basically would act like a buffer and make sure that we're keeping the drop case packer fed, not worrying about the laner getting stuck or small stop issues, and being able to have more of those bottles build up before we take down the labeler. And then kind of the next stage, if it makes sense for the project, would be to add a buffer between the filler and the labeler, add like a spiral conveyor to hold another 1,000 bottles, and try to break up some of those downtime events between those two pieces of equipment. So by using process analysis, we're able to quantify OEE increases based on what we're doing to conveyor speeds and equipment speeds and adding new equipment. And then that can be used to help with ROI calculations and figure out whether a project is viable and how far we go with that project in adding new equipment. Thank you for watching. Please look in the description below for a link to our website and other great content.